Hi uncle, how are you doing?
Now that I've seen you and know that you're a lot of followers in the YouTube.
Uncle?
Add my name also there. I said, what is the topic of discussion today?
The topic is, I have few questions for you, actually. Regarding this pandemic and current situation and disturbances happening across the nation and the current
Please go ahead.
Yeah. So first of all, welcome to my channel, uncle. Welcome to my Anvita vlog. Since you are a very, very great personality that I have known and you are a very good contact that I have had. And you usually be in national media. And thanks for being in my channel. And it would have been harder for me if you were not married to Andhra Pradesh. And how is auntie?
She's fine. She's doing very well.
Okay. UNICEF and WHO and many other organizations have said that if India reaches the level of community spread, that will be a very worst condition that any country could face. And do you think the India facing now, the second wave, is this the community spread or do you think that yet it have to be faced by the India?
I assure you, see, I assure you as a senior doctor, I assure you as a responsible doctor of the country, there's nothing like community spread as of now. Don't go on social media totally. Don't believe all that you read in newspapers. Don't believe all that you see in newspapers. All media news channels, they may be correct to some extent, but not to full extent. Not to full extent. Have faith in yourself. Have faith in your doctor. Have faith in your hospital. Have faith in your state government and central government. No pain will be spared to protect each and every citizen of the country from this COVID as well as from any other deadly disease. I can assure you. The doctors, nurses, paramedics, social servants, social people, all are awake for this mammoth, I repeat, this mammoth disaster epidemic that we are facing. And I want, through your blog also, people to come out, join hands, but in whatever small or big manner they can do, that will be the biggest contribution of them to this big, now great country. Start from your village, start from your mohalla, enlarge it to your district and to your state. Do as much good to your brother, sisters, as you can do. A lot of people require help from you.
Well,
Anvita, the topic which you're used is very pertinent, very relevant, and is the need of the hour. The whole country, from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, from Gujarat to far northeast, is suffering from a dreaded disease known as COVID-19, named by COVID-19 because it was first time noticed in November, December of 2019. That is about 1.5 years back. It started from when people started reporting high fever, malaise, and serious condition requiring them to get hospitalized in a Chinese city, popularly known as Wuhan, W-U-H-A-N. People have got a thinking that possibly when we disturb the nature, when we disturb the ecology, the normal system of ecology goes away. In this case, the virus normally remains in the non-humans. This means it could be in a bat, it could be in a rat, but never in a human being. But once we disturb the ecology, once we disturb their homes, the virus jumps. Jumps means it goes from a bat to a living human being. And as we are aware, people in the far east, that's from Vietnam, Cambodia, China, and those Taiwan, those country people enjoy eating even the reptiles. In India, even those who are non-vegetarians do not eat bats, do not eat dogs, do not eat snakes. But in certain parts of the world, even those things are eaten up. So it is a presumption, it is a postulation that this virus, which was having normal presence in the bats and reptiles, jumped to human being through that live market. Since then, it has percolated down to each and every country of this world, whether it's a very cold country or a very hot country. It is in Europe, it is in Kashmir, Switzerland, it is in America. America is a huge, huge country, with Phoenix being very hot and Washington being very cold. So some above normal temperatures and below zero degree temperatures. In both, these viruses survived. That is the reason why people speculate it is a man-made. It's a synthetic. The reason, the rationale is, if you see the Karnataka mango, the Andhra mango. Andhra mango doesn't come in the north. You can bring in the by courier, but the tree doesn't grow. The coconut tree, whatever body you eye and you may do, but it would not give fruit. Even if it give fruit, that fruit would not be as tasty. The water would not be as tasty as in the coastal Andhra Pradesh. But this, if you've got a synthetic plastic, like this mobile is made of synthetic thing. This, my glasses are made of synthetic thing. Whether I use them in Kashmir, Jammu or Kanyakumari, the effect and impact is the same.
So you think this is
because it is synthetic.
Part of a conspiracy or something?
I don't say all those things because that is beyond my, as a doctor, it is not beyond my purview. I'm not an expert in that part. But all I'm saying, all indications are in the suggestion that possibly this is a man-made thing. That conspiracy our part is a different investigative agency's job. As a medical doctor, let me be away from all those things.
And my next question is, Uncle, being the additional director of Healthcare Protocol of India, and can you please let the people of our country know what are the medical developments that have happened in past, this, especially after the COVID, past 1.5 years or 2 years, what are the medical developments and between the second wave and first wave?
See, 3-4 very large developments have occurred. One is citizens of this country who are thinking every responsibility is of the government, whether it is district government, state government, or national government, have started realizing that it is their first responsibility to protect by use of the mask. And the mask has not to be casual. It has to be tight on the nose thing and the chin. Both have to be covered thoroughly. People have started using the mask, and you should use double mask when in public. Hand sanitize your hands or use any ordinary, simple, low-cost soap and clean your hands as many as time as you touch a new surface. If you're in your own office or your own home, you need not do that time and again. Maintain a social distance. In India, otherwise also, the culture of India was that you don't come too close to other person. We have got a system of namaste, means maintain a distance of 6 feet, 5 feet, and do namaste. Don't hug, don't shake hand. So those things have been found to be more relevant even today. That's part one. Our health infrastructure, which was gearing up already, has got attention of the public, citizen, as well as the government. Public, citizen, as well as the government. So that everybody is now focusing on the self-health. They are ready for developing the primary health centers in a better way. Hospitals. Third, in the month of end April, India is short of oxygen. With the real, with the intervention of the central government, intervention by the Honorable Court, virtually every hospital is developing its own oxygen generators. So that for oxygen, they don't have to depend on anybody else. Yesterday, Delhi Honorable Delhi High Court has passed an order that every hospital of a minimum strength has to have an oxygen generator so that they don't have to depend on cylinder oxygen. And they have said, dilute the building bylaws. Suppose somebody doesn't have that much space, they said dilute the building bylaws. So that is second development. Third, a new thing has come up in the India that is known as an oxygen concentrator, which was not seen earlier. It's similar to RO system that you have in our kitchens. RO system that we have in our offices for water. That absorbs 90% of the nitrogen and other gases. So what comes out of the machine is almost 90% oxygen. It generates from the atmosphere and it is very useful. Up to 1 to 5 liter of oxygen can be produced by the oxygen concentrator round the clock. And that's very, very good for patients of bronchial asthma, patients of respiratory disease, patients of COVID. And I myself have treated over 100 patients by domiciliary oxygen concentrator. Next thing is, country was not producing enough amount of gloves, personal protection kits, masks, caps, and surgical things, which government has given a big boost so that those things were being manufactured in India more than anywhere in the world. More than anywhere in the world. Next thing is, India developed its own vaccine. India developed its own vaccine, one totally by independence, and secondly by collaboration of one foreign company. And possibly, the government is working hard on that, patent regime will be washing away. So more manufacturers, more drug manufacturers who got facility of manufacturing would be able to manufacture the vaccine within India. And that will come going to be very that you must be reading in the newspapers. The research and design organization that doesn't make only the missiles or planes. They also make human beneficiary medicines. They've got a beautiful laboratories in Ladakh, Leh, as well as in India. So they have come out with a very novel formula that is a falsified glucose, where the virus feels that it is consuming the natural glucose while it is consuming a forged, non-effective glucose. And then its duplication, multiplication gets stopped. But that is only a supplement. That is not a bullet. So those are new things which are being developed in the country. And I'm sure with this sad experience, possibly we will emerge out to be more stronger and much better in the times to come.
Yes. Uncle, the people of the country want to know, what is the 2DG drug? Is it a formula or... that is something, a speculation to control the anger of the people.
Anvita, I just told you that DRDO had developed a 2G drug.
Yeah.
This is a drug which is a supplement. What is a supplement? Like you have coffee in the morning. Okay. Yeah. You add on something. So it is not a replacement of existing medicine. Okay. All it says, the requirement of oxygen could be reduced. It doesn't say that it will save the lives. It will make the life more comfortable.
Okay. Uncle, then I'm jumping to my next question. And these days, we were
Welcome. Learning
a lot about black fungus or mycosis. And there are many satires about this on social media. And there's no proper single news about this. And there are like a lot of speculations and a lot of confusion about what is this actually is. And can you please explain what this black fungus is?
Anvita, you are very intelligent. You asked a very good question. I'm very happy. First, what is a fungus? Like you know, there's organism which can affect us are virus and bacteria. But the atmosphere has got another slow-growing particle known as fungus. The disadvantage of fungus is that it grows slowly and affects gradually. There's something known as facilitative. It is like a facilitative organism. All of us, in my nostrils, in my mouth, in my intestine, there's some bacteria which is there. which are required. That's why whether you see somebody or not, you can know by the smell of the person that this person has entered my room. This person was in the room. What does dogs do, sniffer dogs do? The same thing. They can take the body odor. And that body odor is manufactured by common sense. I'm repeating the word common sense. C-O-M-M-A-N-S-A-L. These are normally my body has good news. They are useful bacteria. They produce B-complex in the body. They produce a lot of enzymes in the body. And they are required for survival. Well, some doctors prescribe a lot of stronger medicines. Some patients require very strong medicines. I'm not naming them. While patient in ICU or severe diabetes, a lot of strong medicines were being prescribed and continue to be prescribed. They kill these common cells. They kill the bacteria which are present in my body or your body or anybody else's body. They're specific. Every one of us doesn't have the same bacteria. That's why every one of us doesn't smell the same. So those are killed. So while the space is vacant, so the fungus comes and sits there. This is an atmosphere. This is facilitative, opportunistic infection. Because COVID virus affects nasopharynx. Nasopharynx means my nose and posterior part of my nose, which can be seen in the throat. Nasopharynx. So there the fungus, which is in atmosphere, comes and sits there. Body doesn't have much defense because of strong medicines. They've been given in ICU. This fungus grows. Okay? Body has not seen this kind of fungus in the past. Body doesn't have a defense. Defense have been suppressed by the stronger medicine that was required in last week or 10, 15 days back. So this fungus grows. And fungus is one organism which is difficult to grow and is difficult to be killed. Different to go and difficult to be killed. Now, as this fungus grows in the nasopharynx, that is the area of behind my nose and the area of my throat. So that area is a very vital area. This fungus chokes. So everything from eyes to brain to ears is in that area. That connection is there. So this fungus grows in those areas, blocks the normal pathway, obstructs the normal functioning. Like eyes, I got some secretion which comes from the eye to the nostrils. That's why if you put an eye drop, you will have the taste in the mouth. It comes from the nostrils. So those channels are blocked. Eyes cannot properly function. Then through those channels, the fungus goes up from the nostril. It is going through those channels to the eyes. So affecting the vision. So that's why it is very dreaded and bad disease. And needs to be curbed in the beginning. Now, Government of India has suggested all the state governments to declare it as a notifying disease. Notifying disease means suppose somebody's got black fungus, it has to be reported to the government. It is notifiable now. And government is taking adequate steps to combat this.
And the last question, there is a fight happening in Andhra Pradesh government. Currently, there is a strain called Andhra Pradesh strain. They are telling that this is a new kind of new strain in coronavirus and more powerful. And there is an FIR that have been made between the government and the opposition party of the state. And can you please explain what is this AP strain? Is it real or like it's not a real one?
See, Anvita. This virus is a friable virus. Okay? This keeps on changing its profile. Just like we change our shirts, our clothes from morning to evening, evening to tomorrow. So this virus also is changing its profile, its shape. Once you change the shape, its qualities also change. Its harmful things also change. So that is still under investigation. But we all know that virus is mutating, is changing its shape. So there could be a strain of Andhra Pradesh, which is still being investigated, still in the laboratories. So we have to wait and watch what the actual picture is. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Anu. Thank you for giving your valuable time and sparing some time out of your busy schedule for me. And we love you
and
so
you're
much.
You're always welcome. What you're doing is social service. I will always like to contribute and help you as much as possible. My best wishes, continue working the social service. My best wishes for you and your husband and family.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Bye.